So after we print it in single layer, we will now go to multi-layer printing. I will select the same file. So go to my sample images and take the gypsy girl and reposition her 130 mm height. There is a position button actually for middle, left and right. Also vertical and diagonal, vertical and horizontal, but you can drag and drop to any position you like, of course, or you can type the numbers. What I want to do now is print this image, color and white at the same time, and I will show two methods. First, let me define my printing mode, because for the demonstration, I prefer that things go a bit faster, so both white and color in fast printing using large fixed dot only will increase the speed. Apply. Send to my layer editor, print my selected layer, and print this file in color and white at the same time. So two files will arrive in my layer editor, and I will print this on a plexi plate. But since I will show this twice, I can give a double example. I can print the color on top of white, or I can print the white on top of the color, of course. So if I start my my layer editor tool now, I can change my layer mode, and I would like to start by printing color on top of white. So I see here unlayered. This will mix the colors. This is not what we want for the moment. We want to print in layers. Color white on varnish, varnish on color white, color varnish on white. This is the one I need, you would say, but hey, we're not doing varnish. We don't need to. It's just this dash on dash, which marks the fact that two layers are used. White is the bottom one that will be obliged to use. And then I can choose to use color or varnish, or I can mix them both even. So in this case, this is my selection. As you can see, the white is a must. Color and varnish are also selectable. Updates and my images are still running in. So as you can see, I have these two images, white color. They enter with the same name as my first test, but by the date created, time date stamp, I can see that these are my newest ones. I can check the preview. So this is clearly a color layer. The pink icon shows that. If I click on the other gypsy girl, the white icon shows me this will be white ink. It shows as a black silhouette because, of course, the screen can't show the difference between white background and white imaging. But anyhow, at the same position, my two layers. Close the preview. And I can select just like this color, or I can double click and the file enters the right layer automatically. So you see, I will print two layers in one table movement. If I just hit the print button now. So the lights are a bit reflecting on the plexi of my machine, makes it difficult to film this. But if you look closely, you see the white layer appearing and the color layer is coming right behind. So he will finish the image in one table movement by splitting up the head. The next example will show the same exercise without splitting up the head and by using a double table movement. Our first double layer print is successful, and I'll now show a second method of doing so. I can reuse the same files. I could actually reprint them, but not necessarily, the files are present. From using this predefined color varnish on white, which is working just like all the other ones you see here, which is working in single table movement, I will switch to multi-table movement. As you can see now, my layers are no longer predefined. I can mix color, white, varnish, I can mix resolutions. And let's do the opposite exercise. What we just did was color on top of white. I will print the white on top of the color since it's a transparent plate anyway. So that means my first layer in this case has to be the color I select, and my second layer will be the white, which will cover up the color file. Hit the print button and the machine will start producing the file. So now my machine is printing the white layer only, sorry, the color layer only, and that will be followed by the white layer. So the color layer will not be so visible. In the reflection of the light, you see something popping up once in a while. The white layer will of course be more visible. The time of printing is hardly different. What we did before was printing with half the head, half white, half color. So my machine printed at 50% of its regular single layer speed. Now he's printing at full speed, but he needs to do two tables. So in the end, it gives the same result. The reasons to use this are various. With the multi-table, you can go up to 15 layers. You can combine resolutions. You can even multiply the layers for structure, for thicker printing. While the single table movement will usually produce higher photographic quality, since you are printing in more passes. So my color layer is nearly finished. It's difficult to see, but it's there. The machine will bring the table forward and move back to start automatically, without any intervention, to start the second layer. That should be white ink. So my color ink is disappearing, as you can see, and white ink coming over to cover it, which means my image will be visible from the other side of the plexi panel. So there we go, the color image, the first one we had. And if I flip over, I get a second color image, this time on the inside of the plexi. Two different methods to do multi-layering.